Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to yet another episode of Kid Icarus Uprising. On the last episode, we took out Phosphora, another one of Reedy's commanders, who was at the Thundercloud Temple. She doesn't live there or anything, she was just kinda freeloading there, hiding from Pit. But that's besides the point. We're probably going after Viridi next, right? Cause that's what Pit said. He's like, I'm coming for you next, Viridi! And yeah, that's what we're gonna do. But as promised, I'm gonna be showing you the other mode in together mode. Light versus dark. So, in this mode, there are two teams of three, the light team and the dark team. It's pretty random. It's random who you get to be on. They choose for you. Doesn't really matter. But the objective is to kill the other team, and a bar will go down in the bottom, at the bottom of the screen. Oh my god, 4 minutes. So there'll be two bars at the bottom of the screen, one for the light team, one for the dark team. As people die on either side, their bar will go down. Once that bar reaches zero, and the last person to die before it reaches zero will turn into an angel. The light team will turn into, well, one of the light team's members will turn into Pit, and the dark team will turn into Dark Pit if it reaches zero. While you're Pit or Dark Pit, you have improved strength, health, and just all your stats are beefed up. But if you die, your team loses. So you become the win condition, essentially. So it's a very team-oriented one. If you become the angel, it's best for you to hide or just kind of try to camp. I know that's frowned upon in first-person shooters, but we're not playing a first-person shooter. We're playing Kid Icarus Uprising. It's very power-oriented. You can do several combos with your powers. I've got these iTrack orbiters. They're a very cheap, very, very cheap weapon. A lot of people don't like them. The reason being, they have insane tracking ability, so much that they circle around and hit multiple times. So you could use a combo with this, use the quick charge, which makes your charge shots charge up faster, and just relentlessly shoot all these charge shots at an enemy and just annihilate them. But there are walls. What if walls get in your way? Well, that's why you have Slipshot. That allows you to shoot through walls. And I have a few other powers like Interference, which essentially just takes away the HUD from a foe. Very useful if you just want to sneak around. Don't want them to see you. So I'm on the Dark Team. So I start by just putting on my Quick Charge and Slipshot and try to find the other team. I like sticking with my team. Oh, there's one. So I'm gonna try to... I could have put some speed stats on these orbiters, but they're really hard to make. What's shooting at me? Oh, he's up there. See, they just... they're so cheap, man. Yeah, I really need, like, stamina or something on these orbiters. Maybe I'll try to fuse them later, but for right now, this is the best I could do. Yeah, there's just a crowd of people over there. This is where these things come to play really good. Like, there's that wall over there. Oh, no. Oh, that's my worst enemy, the reflect barrier. So the light team is almost there. You can see their bar is almost done. So Pit's going to be coming out soon. Oh, that's a power-up drop right there. That gives you invincibility, so I want that. Okay, so I'm just pretty much invincible right now, so I can just... pretty much the star man. My only complaint is the quick charge doesn't last as long as I'd like it to. And Pit is out! And he's using Dark Pit's theme for some reason. I actually like this mode more than the free-for-all, just because there's... I guess I kind of like the objective. It's really fun to play. I'm kind of just, well, I guess we're decimating this team right now. No thanks to my really cheap weapons. Okay, there's Pit. So you want to go after him. That's your primary target. But he has... I don't want to melee. Why are you meleeing? I do not want to melee. There we go. This should do it. Yeah. And I won the game, no less. That's awesome. There's my character helping Pit up. Friendly competition. Sorry I was blowing you up earlier. Here's a hand up. Like I said, and it gives you random rewards there too. Ooh, let's ignore that. Because I want to use that weapon for a later chapter. Yeah, that's light versus dark. Like I said, the multiplayer is... I don't want to fight again. The multiplayer is a very, very in-depth one. It's... People kind of left it after Smash Brothers came out. But the way you could just stick powers and different weapons together, it really makes a different game every time. But let's head back to my Let's Play file. Shouldn't be going on my main file too much anymore. And let's do the next chapter. For this chapter, I decided to use a cannon. I settled on this Twin Bellows cannon. I think it has a good rapid fire. I've never used it before. I think it has a good rapid fire and has a natural burning ability, I think. But let's just use it. It has some pretty good stats. Overall defense. Always never hurts to have more defense. Power attack, that is pretty useless, I think, because I don't have any powers that do attacks. Maybe I should stick on a mega laser. Oh well, full health boost. That just increases my attack power if my health is full. But let's jump into this next chapter, which has a very strange name. Mysterious Invaders. Weren't we going to be facing Viridi? That's kind of a strange title. Well, this one has an intensity gate. 6, in fact. So, let's turn this on and jump in. And it's kind of funny how every chapter, something funny's been happening when Pit leaves the door. Like in chapter 13, he was singing. The last one, the door blew up. But check out what happens in this one.
Oh, I'm so sleepy.
Sorry to drag you out so early, but we've got an emergency. We have a big problem, bigger than all of us gods.
Huh? What is that? It's ransacking the earth.
Enemies incoming!
So, new enemies.
They're firing on me.
I'm not even sure what they are.
So yeah, Pit was all sleepy when he left the door. Go from an adrenaline rush to...
Who's giving the orders?
Maybe they're a new unit of the forces of nature?
Come on now, do they look natural to you?
Morning, do-gooders!
Don't tell me you two are behind this.
Sadly, no. Though I do applaud any and all violence directed at you.
Plus, you should know that I'd never work with Hades. In fact, I was about to destroy him when they suddenly appeared.
No, they saved her at the last minute.
So you have no idea what they are?
I'm sure know-it-all Palutena is just dying to illuminate us.
Unfortunately, I don't know any more than you do. I can only tell you that they're not of this world.
You mean they're... invaders from space?
They're not just invading! This swarm is harvesting whole sections of the Earth! They're like bees taking pollen back to whatever hive they call home!
Not to quibble over details, but I think locusts are a more apt analogy. But whatever they are, they must be stopped. Earth is my flower to plunder, not theirs.
Why have you done everything around here? Forces of nature, drop the hammer!
I guess the Underworlders will get in the mix too. Shoot anything that moves.
Still can't get along, I see.
Just do what you can and try to stay out of the thick of things.
So, the Underworld and Forces of Nature just primarily target these new
I've never
foes?
Seen anything like this!
These things are tough! But what are they?
Huh?
Villains are no match for Pyron!
Pyron? The sun god Pyron?
The one and only.
This wacko's the sun god?
Well, that's what he calls himself anyway.
Ah, so you're all together. Good. Pyron loves a party.
Listen, do you know anything about these enemies?
Of course. They're the Aurum. And this castle of floating islands is just one of their bases.
Just one of their bases? How much more hell do they plan to raise?
Let me drop a little knowledge on you.
Oh, goody.
It's all in the Book of Divine Prophecy, chapter 84, section 3. Beckoned by destruction and corruption, the Aurum are born from and return to nothing. They travel across the galaxy to swallow up the heavens, land, and seas.
I don't remember that passage.
I'll break it down for you, godlings. The Aurum are gonna eat the entire Earth. But stow your fear. Hieron has a delivery, and their return address is justice.
We can trust this guy, right?
You know things are dire if that's the guy we're listening to.
Fear the wrath of my pyroblasters, space weirdos! Ha 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 ha! Kablooey, kablooey!
Yes, let's let Hieron take care of this. We'll take the other side of the islands.
Good plan.
This part of the song always reminded me of Wizard of Oz, the tornado scene. But anyway, Pyron, he's based off Apollo, the sun god.
This is out of control!
The Aurum are blowing up the Earth, and then taking the pieces for themselves!
If they're like bees, what are they doing with it all? Making honey?
Greedy, it was you in Hades who lured the Aurum to our world.
What?! That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard!
Well, Pyron said they're beckoned by destruction and corruption. They were likely drawn here by the war between the underworld and nature.
Convenient how you've forgotten your little tip with the underworld.
Convenient how you've forgotten a massive recent ball visible from space.
You, Zippet, the Aurum are the aggressors here. We're the victims.
You're absolutely right. Like it or not, we're on the same side now. We're heading to the center of the Aurum Islands. That tower is the key to stopping all this devastation. Prepare for land battle.
Okay.
So let's get on the subject of Pyron again. There's a funny thing to mention about his voice actor. I think it's Troy Baker. He also does another character in this game, and you'll never guess who. Troy Baker is also the voice of Arlon. Kind of a contrast there, huh? So you go from this refined individual to Shablamity! Shablamity Justice! It's such a talented guy.
The future?
The Aurum must have stolen materials from all over to build this place.
I wonder how many other planets were harvested to make it.
They're being patched together. Everything seems pretty structured.
If the Aurum are like bees, that's no surprise. Bees are orderly colonies. Likewise, the Aurum seem to act as one. And I doubt these drones have any sense of free will.
There's all this activity here, but no actual light. It's pretty creepy. At this point, I'd expect a boss or something. And he'd be like,
Wahaha! I've been waiting for you, Pit!
Aw, poor Pit. Are you feeling lonely? Because I can call in one of my commanders to keep you company.
I was just kidding. I'm fine.
Taking out targets like that is the key to moving past certain obstacles.
Or I could just go, Woohoo! And fly over them entirely.
You know I can't enable the power of flight right after you've used it.
I know. But it sure would be nice.
Sheesh! Talk about passive aggressive.
So another thing to mention about Pyron, based off Apollo, or maybe even Helios. Okay, so we fought the Immortal Phoenix in Chapter 10. Palutena is based off of Athena. Then we have Pyron here, who's based off Apollo. That could mean nothing. Whatever. The music here is very jazzy. Probably noticed. I'm not a big fan of it. I don't hate it, but it's not like my favorite tracks. The Aurum music, as I like to call it. And these are the Aurum, too. Yeah, these are our new items. These next few chapters, I don't know about them. They don't really mesh too well with the overall story. The arc after this, though, is my favorite. I'll be gushing about that later. The Aurum are kind of weird, because they don't talk. Most of the dialogue is going to come from Viridi and Hades, who are also fighting these things, so we have a common enemy right now. But you can still destroy underworld troops and forces of nature just to get the hearts. Nothing really comes of it, like they won't... There's no, like, friendship system or anything. And these enemies shoot black holes, too. You want to get cover after you do it. Or just deal with them. And a very prominent aspect about this is... Every enemy has a little arrow above it with a color. That just kind of signifies who they're working for.
Are those enemies waving at me?
They're not saying hello, if that's what you're asking.
Those Aurum enemies are known as Zaurums. Their attacks can confuse you, so don't stop to say hi.
Like you said, those things confuse you. Confusion isn't the worst, like it is in other games. You can just sort of stand in one place and it won't affect you, and just kind of dodge around. It can get annoying, but it's not the worst. So this is like the Thundercloud Temple chapter, where you hit that glowy thing to make the path progress. So we just hit glowy thing a few times. Glowy thing. Oh my god, how many hits does it take? But there's our path. I'm liking this cannon so far. I wish I had better modifiers on it. That'd be a lot better. You don't want to go for that item over there. You don't want to do anything but progress here. I think an underworld troop will fight that. Or no, that's a pew-pew. You go pew-pew. Oh, whatever, I'll do it.
Huh? An elevator into a torture chamber. Convenient!
Hades, did you put that treasure box there?
Me? I would never.
Oh, it's a mini cutie!
That's strange.
Could the Aurum have brought it here?
So the Aurum are replicating mini cuties? Weird. There's probably nothing suspicious beyond that. You don't want to go for... There's a hot spring over there, but you'll miss a treasure if you go for it right away. So what you want to do is go up these stairs first, and then jump in the hot spring.
I'm feeling the healing.
I hope for your sake that's a hot spring, and not some other kind of puddle.
They made a pee joke. Oh my god, guys, they made a pee joke. If you caught that too, Hades said hell in an E-rated game. That was like a big deal when I was a kid. Like hell, they said hell? How could they? And here comes one of my favorite Hades lines right now.
Hey look, an exotank!
Hey look, who cares?
It doesn't make sense.
I certainly didn't put it there.
Well, since it's here, I might as well use it.
There's a jump up ahead.
You're gonna fall, you're gonna fall.
I do that to, like, when people say, hey, look, something. I go, oh, hey, look, who cares? One of the many lines I've stolen from this game and transferred it to the reel. So this, I hate this treasure chest so much. You only have two chances at it. And I don't want the, I'll just let them duke it out. And I don't like, no, Oh my god. Okay, back this up. I hate the exotank. The control is so bad. They say how bad the Aether Ring is at controlling. Okay, so you're gonna have to boost over this jump and bail. No!
No!
Nice one, kitty!
Well, you have another try at it. You have lots of tries at it. It just depends if you lose your exotank. You only have two tries if you lose your exotank. What you wanna do is bail off! Ugh! This is making me angry. Okay, let's just try this. I'll eventually get it. This is probably the treasure chest I fail at the most. I got that one in Pandora's Labyrinth pretty fast. But this one is a whole other can of worms. Bail! Okay, got it, good. And Jetstream Orbiters, which aren't that great. But the speed for this cannon is kind of just negligible, I guess. Just want to boost through here. Because the intensity gate is right over here. It's another boost to success.
There's another treasure box.
All hail the goddess of obvious.
We're going to ignore that treasure chest because we're going to be going back there anyway. Oh, don't kill me before I get out. Get that. I don't really need that. But it looks like nothing's in here, but it's hidden behind there. So you could just speed off in your exotank and don't know what you missed. Uh-oh. One of those Aurum shield enemies. Oh, bump the mic. Where's that treasure chest Palutena told me about? Right there. Let's get it.
Oh,
No.
What elegance, what grace, what disturbing brutality.
No.
Pitt doing his best Shia LaBeouf impression again. We dealt with that Mimicutie. Oh, I better jump out of this. It's gonna blow up. Okay. It really hurts you if it blows up with you inside of it. Okay. You'd think there'd be a treasure chest right here, but there's not.
I placed a grind rail up ahead for you.
Thank you very much.
Don't thank me yet. It didn't turn out exactly as I'd hoped. It got a little weird.
Not a problem. I eat weird for breakfast. All right. But it is kind of crooked.
Something seems to have distorted it.
The nerve of those aura! How dare they mess with your godly powers?
Sorry about that, Pit.
Like, half her grind rails are all weird. Why is she complaining about this one? This one seems normal compared to the other ones. Arum did her a favor. In fact, I'd say it's placed pretty well. We could see the islands. We're not going to those islands, so well. It's actually a conversation where Pit complains that, why doesn't the grind rail just go right to the boss? Wouldn't that be easier? She's like, no, I can't do that. But why not? She's like, oh, I just can't do that. Just kind of meta humor there. Okay, this enemy's really annoying. I don't know if I want to deal with it. Oh well.
Your attacks were making that bag low counterattack.
Couldn't you have mentioned that earlier?
Okay, this is a really difficult enemy. I got it, though. And it gives you a treasure chest. That's why I wanted to get it. I missed that treasure chest last chapter. Where those clobberers were with the mines. You're supposed to kill the clobberers and you get a treasure chest. I don't think it's needed for a gold laurel, but I don't know. You need treasure chest if you're ever treasure chest farming. You want to do that. I think the gold laurels are just there if you hit the intensity gates.
This is the last of the grind rails.
Watch me stick the landing!
Be really careful here. I thought one of these gave you food, but it seems like that's not the case. Man, that looks so far away. Usually they give you enemies to shoot at. Oh, there. Hello, enemies to shoot at. So the grind rail sections aren't too boring. But they can't hit you, so they are kind of boring. I can't believe Pit's lugging around this twin bellows cannon, too. Just a few left. So forces of nature are green, underworld is purple, and Arum are blue. This kind of really light blue, or cerulean, whatever color that is. You can only get this enemy when you get inside of his thing. His shield. And these wheel enemies, they rarely ever hit me. Kind of remind me of, like, Link to the Past, when the tiles hit you. But they don't really... They're easy to avoid. Ooh, a jump bomb. This just, like, makes a whirlwind that the enemies float on. It's not that great of a item. Where's the exit? Right there.
There's a path down through that tower.
Then let's go there.
So I should just keep going down this way?
I'm picking up high energy readings from the base of the tower. You can head there, I think.
Oh, sounds like someone's losing her nerve. I guess I'd better step in. Get in here, boys. It's time for some underworld army action.
So the underworld doesn't attack you, but they're going down there. So you can shoot them if you want for hearts, but... They just get destroyed anyway by the Arum.
Well, that didn't go very well.
I think we should just leave this to Pit.
Oh, sure. You want me to pick up your dry cleaning too?
Now, Pit. Viridi has faith in you, and so do I. I know you can handle it.
I'll do my best. Only you.
Pit certainly is devoted to you, Palutena.
Only because she squeezes his head rate when he doesn't follow orders.
You mean, like this?
No! You'll squeeze my brains out! I always fall for that.
Nicely done.
Thank you.
Who knew Pretty Palutena possessed a sense of humor?
Very funny.
You sadistic bitch. Here he is, going into enemy territory when no one else will, when everyone else is getting destroyed, and you're making jokes about that. You're such a bitch, Palutena. Ugh. The things Pit does for this goddess. She treats him like shit like that. Almost getting him killed multiple times with her glam blaster and sending him through caves, which are active volcanoes. I'm gonna stop complaining though, because we're almost at the boss. There are another one of those counter-attack enemies. Just don't bother with it, because you can just leave. If you're that desperate for the hearts, then go for it, but I don't like fighting it, especially on higher intensity levels.
So that's what I need to destroy?
Only one way to find out?
The shield is so annoying!
There are gaps in it that expose the core. Keep circling around the shield and shoot the openings. You might want to take care of those outer guns, too.
So, like she said, take out the outer guns. This makes this fight a lot easier.
I don't know what I'd do without him.
That's really nice of you, Lady Palutena. You're the reason I go on fighting every day.
It seems we have a little mutual admiration society here.
Isn't that sweet? And by sweet, I mean disgusting.
I wouldn't expect you two to know anything about loyalty or devotion.
I know sappiness when I see it.
Hear, hear.
That's enough from the cheap seats.
So anyway, where were we?
Well, Viridi has some loyal and devoted servants. I call them servants. She had Phosphora and Arlon, but Pit kind of took them out. So this fight's not hard at all. Just take out the guns and you should be fine.
Pulverized!
Let's see what happens.
You all right there, citizen?
A-okay.
Thanks for your help, Pyron. Pit, let's regroup.
Whoop! Pyron senses danger. And now Pyron sees it.
Pyron likes talking in the third person.
Like I said, I'm just gonna keep all these. Just so I can maybe fuse them later into better weapons. Oh, instant death attack. That's a really good power. I'm very glad I got that before a certain chapter. We didn't get any achievements for that, wow. Well, we have a new enemy, again, but it seems all our past enemies are on our side now, and we have a common goal, get rid of these Aurum, who are trying to eat the earth, pretty much. So, we'll continue our Aurum struggles next time, ladies and gentlemen, when we head on to chapter 14. Or 16, sorry. We head on chapter 16, the Aurum Hive. So, I'll see you guys later.